This, guys, is the heart and soul of our off-grid solar system. It is a beautiful fall day here on the homestead. The solar panels, they are in complete sun. Let's cruise inside here, show you kind of what we're running in our house. We've got a bunch of lights on. We've got the ceiling fan on. We've got a Mr. Cool that is a 36K Mr. Cool heat pump that we're using to heat the place today. We've got, of course, standard microwave, a range, standard refrigerator with ice maker and water and all of that stuff like in the door. We've got a 65-inch TV over here, another TV up there, more lights. It's a 3-bedroom, 2-bath house that we're powering just like we were on the grid, but we are not on the grid. Let me show you how it all works. And yes, it's not finished yet, because if you're new here, we are building an off-grid homestead from scratch, debt-free here in North Idaho. And so if you're interested in that kind of stuff and preparedness stuff, well, you might like to subscribe to the channel. Check out our panels. 30 solar panels here, and we're running about 10,000 watts of solar panels. I imagine we're not producing that much right now because, well, our batteries are probably full. We're going to check that out here in just a second. But here's the backside of the panels. These are homemade mounts right here. We got a video on how we made these homemade mounts to hold all of these panels. They're working great. They shed the snow really good in the wintertime. Everything is working fine. We have no faults with our homemade mounts. We've got our power coming down these lines right here from our solar panels. They wrap around and they go up inside of this box. So inside the box, what do we got? Well, we've got breakers, and it goes into this conduit, down into this conduit and underground over to there. And so from here, it comes up out of the ground. It goes into the solar shed. Let's cruise in here, check out our system. Ooh, this, guys, is the heart and soul of our off-grid solar system. Let me show you how it works. So we've got 4 strings of solar panels out there, and they all come in to here. These guys then send power out through this cable and out through this cable, and it goes into this distribution hub right here. From here, if the batteries need charging, well, it comes out of these cables, goes into here, and goes into our battery bank. We'll talk in more detail about the battery bank here in just a second. And then if we need power out of the battery bank, well, then it comes out this wire and this wire, goes into the hub, and then comes out over here and goes up into our 2 inverters right here. Each of these does 120 volts, but when you combine them together with this data cable right here, well, then you can get 240 volts split phase, which allows us to run our well pump and our whole house. It's all wired just like a standard grid home, but we're not connected to the grid. We're only powered by these guys right here. And then it comes out of this wire, and it comes out of this wire, and it goes into this breaker box right here, which then goes into the wall. Let's cruise back outside real quick. Goes into this LB, goes underground over there, into that LB. Oh, and yes, that's another Mr. Cool. It heats and cools the apartment above the garage, but it goes into here, over, up and around, and over to the breaker box where it's all wired up. And I forgot, man. So the 240 doesn't only run the well, it runs that Mr. Cool and the other Mr. Cool as well, because those are 240 volt Mr. Cools. Now these guys right here can also charge the batteries from the generator that's right over here. We gotta go back outside again. Here's the generator right here. And so if we start this guy up and we plug it in, it goes into the wall and then come back inside again. No, it's like in and out, but that's what we got to do. It comes out of the wall and then into each of these, which then in turn comes out of here, over to here, through here, and charges the batteries if we don't have enough sun. All of this would basically be worthless without a good battery bank. But before we talk about the batteries, let's just see what we're using for power. See, batteries that are 100%, we're producing 1400 watts of power, somewhere around, it's bouncing around a little bit. It's coming out of our solar panels. Some of it's going to the battery just to keep it charged a little bit. It's only 23 watts just to make sure everything's good. Then it goes up to the inverters and straight to the house. If the generator is running, we'd see the generator running here, how many watts it's putting out, going into the inverters and then coming down, going to the batteries and going over to the house to power those loads. That is how the whole system works. There's a link to a wiring diagram down in the description below if you want to check it out. Let's talk a bit about these batteries. This right here is the heart and soul of our off-grid solar system. We've got 16 100 amp hour 12 volt lithium iron phosphate batteries. These are Battleborne batteries. That's the company that makes them. And they have been doing super good, guys. We've been running them for a few years now and have absolutely zero issues with them. So let me just show you how they're kind of wired up. They're wired up in series here, right? So these four batteries right here make a 48 volt battery, basically, the way you wire them up. And then this one right here, and this one here, and this one here. So we have four strings of batteries, of four batteries each, that's 48 volts. Then each string of batteries is wired in parallel. So the whole thing together kind of turns into one giant 48 volt battery. In total, we've got over 19,000 watt hours of battery backup right here. And every day, and the sun comes up, recharges them. We use them all night long. We could go for a couple of days without having to charge the batteries off of what we normally use inside of the house. And so why have I been saying for years that this is the easiest off-grid solar powered battery bank out there? Well, it's because I come from the lead acid world, right? And a lot of you guys, if you've got like this colored hair, you probably came from the lead acid world as well. I mean, you were using, right, deep cycle lead acid batteries for your trolling motor. You probably had them in your RV or your camp trailer. You might even have powered your solar system with them, or you still are using lead acid batteries and you're thinking, man, I gotta replace these things, man. I mean, they don't last very long. You can only use 50% of a lead acid battery. And so I got a buddy who's going through this right now in his mind. He knows he needs to replace his batteries. And I'm saying, man, these are what you ought to get, because zero maintenance, zero issues. I mean, look, these guys are on their side. Nothing's going to like run out of it. Nothing's going to spill. You don't have to mess with checking the water levels and checking everything and making sure it's all right. They just work. They've got a little like computer inside of here. It's called a battery management system. And what that does is it protects your batteries. You know, like when we were using lead acid batteries, part of the problem is we'd run them too low because I didn't like watch it close enough. I don't even have to worry about that with these. You cannot drain these guys too far. They will automatically shut off and preserve the battery, save the battery for you. You can't overcharge them. You can't get them too hot. You can't get them too cold, because if it gets too hot, they just shut off. If it gets too cold, they just shut off. You're not going to damage them, in other words, right? Like we damaged our first set of lead acid batteries, and you've probably damaged yours too if you've been using them for any period of time. So totally recommend lithium iron phosphate batteries, and totally recommend Battleborne batteries as the company to go with. It's a premium battery and they are built to last. All right, so you're looking at this and you're thinking, man, I don't know, that doesn't look like the easiest system to me. I mean, look at all those wires and all of that. So why do I say they're the easiest? Because, man, they are a direct replacement for the lead acid deep cycle batteries that we've been using for years, right? I mean, like your grandpa probably used lead acid batteries. And so direct replacement, you hook them up the same, you wire them up the same, they function the same. That's why for some of us who are going gray, these are the easiest, man, easiest. Let me tell you just a little bit about the company, and they are the sponsor of this video. But guys, if they weren't the sponsor, I would still be telling you this about these batteries, because they have provided for our family for years now with no issues. I know I've said that a couple times, but it's just true. So there are over 300,000 Battleborne batteries out in the world, wild, being used by people every day. Man, they have got great customer service. It's based right here in the United States. Technical support, customer service. You're gonna talk to an American when you call them with any questions that you have. They've got free shipping within the contiguous United States. And if you can't like afford the system up front, well, they do have financing available. And if this intimidates you at all, then they have a list of certified installers that can totally help you out and set up your system for you You don't need to do it yourself, right? So like, why go ahead and change out your dying lead acid batteries for a lithium iron phosphate battery like this? Well, I mean, there are a ton of reasons why these are way better than the lead acid batteries that we used to use and you used to use or you still do use. But one is that there is a 10-year warranty on these things. I mean, they are going to last and last and last. The protection system that is built inside of them is like super convenient. No maintenance, right? They charge faster. They hold more power. You don't have to use these things either for like an off-grid setup like this. I mean, they work just like any standard 12-volt deep cycle battery. You could use them for your trolling motor, your RV, your camp trailer, right? Your schoolie, your van, whatever it is that you want to use a deep cycle battery for, you can use one of these with no maintenance. They charge faster, they hold more power, they're super lightweight, and are an easiest drop-in replacement for your 12-volt lead-acid batteries. Now, if you live in a super cold climate, after we got our batteries, they came out with this super cool feature. We don't have it, but I wish I had it, and that is heated batteries. They self-heat themselves when it gets too cold, and it just uses a little bit of power. We don't have to worry about that very often here. Sometimes I've got to run a heater in the shed here, just like a few days out of the winter. When we get down to like negative 20 or so, the shed just can't hold the heat because these guys all produce heat and heat the shed up a little bit, just keeping it warm enough on normal days. But man, when it really drops, I got to run a little heater out here. So if you're thinking about getting your house ready to be off-grid, whether that's just for personal enjoyment or because you know that something may be coming down the pike, man, take a look at Battleborne Batteries. I think you're really going to be impressed with them and their customer service. There's a link down in the description below that you can go ahead and click, or you can scan the QR code that is on the screen here. I want to thank Battleborne for sponsoring this video, and we'll see you guys in the next one. Hope you have a really great day and keep smiling.